We are living in an era where scientific research is backed by technological advances that have enabled us to take massive leaps in terms of what we know. And ever since it started operating, scientists have been making a lot of intriguing discoveries with the James Webb Space Telescope. Webb's first images gave us a detailed look at the early universe, and we've even detected carbon dioxide on an exoplanet with it. Some even speculate that James Webb could be the one to finally solve the mystery of the elusive dark matter and its cousin, dark energy. Within a few months of its foray into the cosmos, James Webb has already forced us to sit up and take into consideration that our well-established theories about the cosmos could have flaws. The most potent telescope in the world at the moment can do wonders for science and also give sleepless nights to the scientists. Join me as we explore one of the most shocking discoveries made by the James Webb Telescope, of a distant galaxy that is located in two places at once. What is this galaxy? What does it tell us about our universe model? And what are the next steps that will be taken by the scientists in light of this bizarre discovery? Orbit. Beyond the blue. Only in July, astronomers found Glass Z13, which was the frontrunner to be the oldest galaxy in the observable universe. But now, a new candidate has entered the chat, and it is so far away that it can break the models of our universe. In a preprint paper, released on August 5, Rohan Naidu, an astrophysicist based at Harvard's and Smithsonian's jointly operated Center for Astrophysics, has detailed another distant galaxy candidate from one of JWST's early release science programs, known as SEERS 1749. It's an extremely bright galaxy that, if confirmed, would have existed just 220 million years after the Big Bang, and it could also rewrite our understanding of the cosmos. But there's a bloody huge catch. SEERS 1749 could be one of the most distant galaxies we've ever seen. Or, it could be lurking much closer to home. Essentially, the data seems to indicate two possible places for the galaxy to be, and we won't know which one is correct without a lot more observation. That's how it earned the title of Schrödinger's galaxy candidate. How can a galaxy like Schrödinger seem to be in two different places? Well, it's all about redshift. To determine how far away a galaxy lies, astronomers study wavelengths of light. Specifically, they're interested in a phenomenon of light known as redshift. In a nutshell, light waves leaving distant galaxies get stretched over time, shifting the waves down the electromagnetic spectrum and making them more, well, red. So, ultraviolet light leaving a galaxy like Schrödinger won't reach Earth as ultraviolet light. Instead, it will be redshifted down into the infrared, which is great for us because that's just the kind of light Webb searches for. And Webb has various filters, looking at distinct wavelengths of infrared. In examining a galaxy like Schrödinger, you can flick through the wavelengths like you might flick through a photo album. On the first few pages, fewer red wavelengths, you won't see a thing. Then, as you turn through and the wavelengths become more red, the ghost of a galaxy appears. In the most redshifted wavelengths, at the back of the album, the galaxy is a clearly defined object. This would also mean we might need to rethink our models of how galaxies evolved in the earliest days of the universe. Galaxies from that long ago should not be this bright, at least according to the model we currently use to explain our cosmos. But maybe we don't need to break physics just yet. It might be that Schrödinger is actually a satellite galaxy of one of its more massive neighbors, and it could be much closer to us. Another group of researchers also studied this exact same galaxy from the early released data, on the same day. Jorge Zavala, an astrophysicist at ALMA Japan, and his team, added to the JWST data, with data from an Earth-based telescopes in the French Alps and Hawaii. They came to the conclusion that Schrödinger might be an imposter, masquerading as a high redshift galaxy, when it's actually a much closer, dusty galaxy undergoing rapid star formation. Scientists now find themselves in a bind, since the data suggests two potential locations for Schrödinger, and no one is yet certain which one is accurate because further investigation and observation are still needed. In particular, spectroscopy will allow astrophysicists to scrutinize its redshift more accurately. The only barrier now is time, getting enough time on telescopes around the world to study Schrödinger and solve the puzzle. But hold on, Schrödinger is only a part of the massive image released by Webb. The images indicate that massive galaxies were already forming in the earliest days of the epoch of ionization, when the plasma that evenly filled the early universe collapsed into more familiar stars and galaxies. Despite its tremendous size and all the ancient galaxies contained within it, the image is just a tiny slice of the sky. Atmospheres of exoplanets that lie in the habitable zone of their stars, artificial lights around exoplanets, and study of the moons of Jupiter and Saturn are only a few of the several investigations the super-powerful telescope will run. Speaking of exoplanets, Webb just clicked the very first image of an exoplanet. Astronomers have revealed the first photograph of an exoplanet taken by NASA's James Webb Space Telescope, JWST. The image shows the bright blob of a world seven times heavier than Jupiter, that orbits a star nearly 400 light-years away. The groundbreaking result is the latest in a slew of early exoplanet findings from the telescope, and a test of technologies that will enable direct imaging of Earth-like planets by future space telescopes. It's exhilarating to say the least. To photograph the hot, young giant, HIP65-426b, JWST blocked the light of its host star using a small mask known as a coronagraph. This revealed the orbiting planet, which is thousands of times fainter, like a firefly around a searchlight. HIP65-426b orbits about 100 times farther from its star than Earth does the Sun, taking 630 years to complete an orbit. This distance means it's easier to see the planet against the glare of the star. That, coupled with the planet's extreme heat and brightness, it has a scorching temperature of about 900 degrees Celsius, a fever left over from its formation just 14 million years ago, which makes it a prime target for direct imaging. HIP65-426b's surface features aren't visible in the image, but Biller said it would probably look banded like Jupiter, with belts caused by variations in temperature and composition, and might have spots in its atmosphere caused by storms or vortices. The giant planet is inhospitable to life as we know it, but it represents a class of large planets that scientists are eager to learn more about. Every week, we wait with bated breath for Webb to show us our cosmos like never seen before. And surely, with more discoveries, more challenges to the existing model of the universe will come forward. After all, what is science if not questioning and rethinking everything we know? But what do I know? Orbit. Beyond the blue.